Hi, Siobhan Sarna here with an update from Kiran Krishnan, who is the co-founder of Microbiome Labs. We've got some breaking news for you. Not only a new product has just been launched, it's sold out, it's just back in stock. It's called FODMATE to help you to really digest those difficult fibers known as FODMAPs. And if you have gut issues, bloating, diarrhea, constipation, alternating diarrhea and constipation, you've been labeled with IBS, you're IBS suspicious, you're SIBO suspicious, get a hold of this, diversify your diet, be able to be free of fear around food. Oh my gosh, what a game changer. This is just the beginning. Kiran, thanks for being here. And tell me what has been going on, because you have been busier even than the busyness and productivity you usually have with all these new developments.
Yeah, absolutely. Well, last year was a crazy year, right? Because crazy. Of course, we were all going through the pandemic. We're trying to figure out how to run our businesses and build the company and all that through that new environment. But at the same time, at Microbiome Labs, we were working hard on finding a global partner that would allow us to take everything that we do at the core and really expand and invest in it, and so that we have much better reach. And we have, we can kind of make all our nerdy dreams come true, right? You're always limited by resources, right? In terms of what you want to and can achieve. And so what we wanted to do is find a way to bring about more resources, more support, so that we can really have a significant impact in the world today. And that's really our big measure of success. Our measure of success is based on human impact, not just dollars and cents, right? So we worked very hard through the second half of last year, looking for the right type of global partner to partner up with, that not only had our same philosophy, our same ideas and passion, but then of course had massive resources and underlying capabilities to support our growth and development. And so we were able to partner up with Novozymes. Novozymes is a large biotech company out of Denmark. They are the largest enzyme manufacturer in the world. So if you've ever taken an enzyme, used detergent, drank a glass of wine or any beverage, really any fruit-based beverage, you've consumed some sort of Novozyme enzyme, because they're really big in dairy, fruit, in beverages, detergents and all that. You see the enzymes in their detergents that actually break down the stain molecules and all that. Those are all types of enzymes that Novozyme produces. Of course, loads and loads of digestive enzymes and so on. What's really exciting about Novozymes is they have this division that they've been building over the last few years called One Health. And One Health is a human health focused division with the focus on finding therapeutic solutions through the microbiome, right? And of course, that fits with us absolutely perfectly. The difference is, they are a multi-billion dollar multinational company, so they have resources that we don't have. So we had the perfect philosophical and cultural fit. And then now we can utilize our ideation, our knowledge base in what is important within the microbiome space. And we can combine that with their capabilities and their resources in order to bring more innovative products to fruition. I can talk about some of those products coming out over the next several months. And then, when you look at some of their capabilities, for example, I was just in Copenhagen last week, visiting the headquarters and the labs and meeting with the science teams and all that. You know, we now have access to over 200 research and development professionals, right? On staff, right? It's a massive, massive scientific team. On top of that, they're connected to all of these universities, almost 40 different universities globally, with some of the top professors and researchers in all of those universities. So we've got a tremendous brain trust of knowledge and information and capability at our fingertips, right? On top of that, we've got now 30,000 probiotic strains that we have access to, right? 30,000, which is absolutely insane. So almost any activity out of a probiotic that we're looking for, right, we can screen this massive library of strains to find ones that have this capability. We're doing a couple of projects like that right now. One of our team members at Microbiome Labs came up with the idea of finding a probiotic that can break down BPA, right? As most people know, BPA is a type of plastic, right? That's found in everything now. It's in our systems. It's found in amniotic fluid and in newborn babies. It's in food, water, everything. And it's really, really a problematic toxin that we cannot get away from. But as it turns out, there are some bacteria that can actually break down BPA to its molecular components that are perfectly harmless, right? So we are screening now, and we've already identified microbes that can do that job, right? We've got a probiotic coming out that binds heavy metals in your gut, right? Lead, cadmium, arsenic. It's a bacteria that gets into your system with your food and your drink and binds up and takes out all the heavy metals out of your system, right? Out of your digestive tract. Isn't that crazy?
Dang.
Yeah. So it has an affinity for heavy metals on its outer surface, right? So we've got another bacteria that we're releasing that actually binds and grabs onto H. pylori in your stomach and takes it out of the system without killing anything else. It just gently grabs H. pylori, holds onto it, and then you poop it out 8 hours later, right? So mind-boggling stuff. And again, we have over 30,000 probiotic strains, and we now have over, I think it's something like 13 million enzymes that we have in our library that we can test and screen for. And we've got high throughput robotic screening where we can screen tens of thousands of samples and, you know, every hour to look for functionalities and ways of mitigating pathways. They also have this micro droplet system that uses lasers, right? Where you can do single drop fermentation. So imagine a tiny little water drop, right? In that little water drop is one bacteria cell. And inside that water drop is a fermentation mix that is designed to figure out which bacteria cell can actually do what type of metabolism. And then you can insert compounds into that single water cell using lasers, and they can screen millions of bacteria and millions of fermentation scenarios in a matter of hours. I mean, this is like next generation nerd dream for me, right? And so it's really like a dream come true for a company like ours that's always focused on science, always focused on innovation. We found the absolute right partner. And the best part about it is they basically said to us, listen, you guys know your market. You know what your doctors need. You know what your audience needs. And so you tell us what we should do together, what we should work on together. And that is the absolute perfect scenario. And on top of that, our clinical trial budget has gone through the roof too, right? So we've just, over the last 2 months, we have initiated the process of starting 6 new clinical trials, and these are large trials, right? These are 50, 100, 200 patient trials on new areas that we're looking at. Of course, FODMAPE is one of the trials that we're starting, which will be super exciting because we want to definitively show that in published literature, the effects of FODMAPE. Our TGR, total gut restoration, is getting a big new trial. Megaspore is getting a bunch of new trials. So we're getting more and more clinical trials as well. So to me, the partnership couldn't have been designed better if I had a magic wand and I was able to design things like that. And we are extremely grateful because we're going to be coming out with some things that are really going to blow your mind. And speaking of mind, actually, the next thing that we're coming out with through our partnership with Novozymes is a probiotic strain called Bifidobacterium longum 1714. This strain has been extensively studied by the number one institute in the world for gut-brain axis research, showing a significant reduction in cortisol and stress throughout the day, a significant ability to cope with daily stress, significant improvement in sleep parameters, so time to sleep, and then sleep efficiency throughout the time that you are sleeping. And here's the crazy thing, also shows that it can shift brainwave function, right? So when your brain is in a predominant beta wave, for example, that means you tend to be heightened. You tend to have a sympathetic activation, nervousness, irritability, and so on. What we've been able to show is just taking this probiotic actually shifts your brainwaves to theta wave function, which is that flow state where you're calm, your brain is highly efficient, your memory recall is improved. All of these things, you're in that flow, creative, functional state, right? So we can change your brain waves with the probiotic. And that's coming out in August.
Oh, good. Yes, I was going to say, what's the timeline for all this? Is August the next one?
August is the next one. The product I was just talking about, the brainwave stress sleep one, is called Zen Biome.
Oh, nice.
Yep. And we have two versions of it. We have Zen Biome Cope. That's for daily stress, for people that are dealing with daily stress and mood issues. And then Zen Biome Sleep to help with sleep efficiency, time to sleep, sleep quality, and so on. So those are the two versions that are coming out sometime by the end of August.
Okay, now everybody, when they launched FODMATE, it sold out so quickly. So as soon as Zen Biome and Cope and Zen Biome Sleep are available, I will get you that info. Yeah. So you can get in the first batches, first in line, because that is going to be huge. I hope you're making a lot, Kiran. I have a couple of other questions about the future. Is there any enzyme or probiotic to help with glyphosate?
Yes, so there's probiotics that can do that. So that's another one that we are screening for. We know from another published study, not our study, but somebody else's, a university study, that Bacillus subtilis, some Bacillus subtilis can actually break down glyphosate. Oh. And we have in our library now 1,700 spore strains, right? We used to have 5 until January. Now we have 1,700 spore strains.
Right. Hey, let's say that again.
We had 5 all this time, which is what we focus all our research and development on, right? Including Megaspore and so on. Now we have 1,700 spore strains in our library, and we're finding strains that do very, very unique things. For example, one of the strains that we're coming out with is a Bacillus velicensis that actually fights against Clostridium difficile. And it specifically targets C. diff in the gut, right? So we've got 18 studies on that strain already done.
I have goosebumps. I'm so excited. That's a lifesaver, guys. That's a lifesaver. Okay, what about, this is just random. These are the things that have come to me since we've been talking. Eyesight. Do you have anything for my eyes?
Yeah, absolutely. So in fact, one of the strains in Megaspore, the Bacillus indicus, produces very high levels of carotenoids, right? And carotenoids are extremely important for eyesight. Things like lutein, beta carotene, those are a critical part of maintaining the functionality of the rods and cones, and of course all the neurological tissue in the eyes itself. So that's another key thing. So we're doing some studies on the use of high doses of the indicus. So the indicus in Megaspore is at 1 billion CFUs, and it produces around 90 micrograms of carotenoids per day at that level. We're looking at going 10 times that amount to dramatically increase the amount of carotenoids being produced. And we want to see if we can increase the amount of carotenoids then that are present in places like your skin or your eyesight, right? So we're starting with the skin study this year. We've got 2 skin studies started because carotenoids in the skin protect the skin and provide the skin resilience, not only against UV damage from the sun outside, but against aging and dehydration related damage. And even maybe more importantly in the modern age, against blue light irradiation from our screens, right? That's a new problem we've created for ourselves that's causing aging and skin damage, is the blue light from all of these screens that we're looking at all day long. Not only are they damaging your eyes, right? We know that they damage your eyes, and you've got glasses like these that you can wear to try to protect your eyes. But that same blue light, the same way it damages your eyes, it strips it of the carotenoids, it damages your skin as well. So we're driving age-related dysfunction in the skin by being in front of our screens. But we're not going to get away from in front of our screens. That's just the reality of life today. So then the question is, how do we protect the skin? And the carotenoid-producing bacteria is going to be the key, I think, because it produces 13 different carotenoids at the most bioavailable level, because these are produced post-gastric in your small intestine, in your large intestine, where they are directly absorbed into the system, right? So they're highly bioavailable, very concentrated, and they produce a really big variety of carotenoids. So So that's going to be a game changer, I think, in terms of eye health. We also have a whole division now on oral health.
That was on my list.
I figured it would be, because we've had conversations around oral health before, and we know that the mouth is a major source of dysbiosis for the entire body, including for the small intestine, but then systemically as well, right? So we're starting out, actually, we're launching probably by October, no, more like November, a product called BioFresh Plus. That product is an enzyme blend that actually breaks down odor-causing molecules in your mouth, right? It's not about masking odor-causing molecules, whether the odor is from food or more than likely bacterial overgrowth, which is what occurs in people's mouth and causes, you know, the morning breath and halitosis and so on throughout the day. This product is not trying to mask the odor by using strong mints and flavors and all that. What it's actually doing is actually breaking down the odor-causing molecules in the mouth so that the odor is completely gone, and a single lozenge will keep your mouth completely fresh and odor-free for 4 to 5 hours straight. Right. So then
that's crazy.
It's mind-boggling. And then you don't have to do all of the sugar mints and the gums and all that stuff in the mouthwash that's alcohol based that actually hurts your oral microbiome even more. You know, all of those things. And in fact, you know, this is the safest and most effective way of maintaining freshness in your mouth. And as we've all now being able to get out there without our masks, being able to talk to each other one-on-one, you know, or in groups close to each other, we need to make sure we're not creating odors out of our mouth, right? Now, the second iteration of that in early next year is one that actually breaks down plaque in your gum lines and on your teeth, right? And it can do it in our preliminary studies. It can break down plaque as well as some of the top electrical toothbrushes can. So one of the ideas we have is maybe we can make brushing obsolete. You know, you just take, well, pop in one of these, you know, these lozenges, you chew around on it, and it actually breaks down plaque better than your toothbrushing, than your hand brushing can, and as good as the electrical toothbrushes can. But here's the key thing. Then you're not using mouthwashes and toothpaste where you're swallowing all, you know, potential chemicals that can have harm to your system. You might be able to actually preserve your oral microbes better, the good microbes, right? Without causing issues with the good microbes. So there's a whole world of that coming out.
Okay, this is huge. Now you have to understand, Kiran and I have been talking about the oral microbiome since day one that I met him. I have just finished taping the Dental Health Connection Summit with almost 50 speakers talking about this. About the oral microbiome and dental health and the whole body dentistry connection. So for me to hear this, and you finally gave me the name of it, thank you, because I've been bugging you about that. I am so thrilled. This is such a huge, huge need. I'm going to get it out to as many people as possible. I cannot wait. Big. Okay. Bile, do you have anything coming for bile stimulation? I know you have some products that already do that.
Yeah, our MegaGuard does help with bile stimulation, but we don't have a particular project right now for bile stimulation. We do, however, have discovered something. As you know, we have our biome effects test, right, which is the most accurate and comprehensive microbiome, you know, stool test there is. And one of the benefits that we have with Novozymes is now we have this massive data science team that can go through all of this data from people's microbiomes and find common issues that seem to be coming up. And through that, we're discovering that there's a pathogen that is rarely talked about and is not at all tested for in other stool tests, because other stool tests use something called PCR to look for pathogens, which means that you have to know what you're looking for because you have to put a little probe in your test for it, right? We don't use PCR. We use whole genome sequencing, which means we're just going to find anything that's there, right? Versus saying, I'm looking for these 8 pathogens and then testing for it. So that if other pathogens other than the 8 are present, you're not going to pick it up. Right. So that's the big advantage of the biome effects. Now going through the biome effects, and now that we've done over 5,000 tests or getting to that point, we're finding that a lot of people have an overgrowth of something called Bilophila wadsworthia, right? And Bilophila was earlier.
Slowly again, because it sounds like you made it up.
Totally, right? It's called Bilophila, B-I-L-O-P-H-I-L-A, and then Wadsworthia with a W, right? So Bilophila Wadsworthia is a small intestine pathogen. It's an opportunistic pathogen. And in fact, it grows, and as the name indicates, Bilophila, it likes bile. So it does grow even in the presence of bile. So even if you have bile functioning somewhat properly, it's still resistant to the function of bile. And to me, it's going to turn out to be the number one culprit in SIBO and IBS. Because Bilophila is a sulfate reducing bacteria, which means it's going to take the products, the foods that you eat that have high sulfates in them, and converts it to hydrogen sulfide, which is super inflammatory for the large bowel. It creates lots of gas. It creates lots of bloating. It can drive reflux disease. It also drives metabolic syndrome and heart disease, right? So all of these things. I mean, it's a pathogen that when you look at it, you go, holy cow, most of the people I've been talking to, this pathogen represents all of their symptomologies, right? And nobody is talking about it. Nobody's doing anything about it. Nobody in the supplement industry even knows it exists, right? And because of our focus on science, our development of the Biome Effects, and then now our partnership with this large, amazing biotech company, we've been able to identify it. And now we are screening our 30,000 probiotic bacteria to find ones that will specifically compete against Bilophila so that we can help people control it. Because I'm telling you, we're seeing it pop up on such a huge proportion of the tests. And as we dig more into the data science, we don't have the strong data yet as to what types of people it correlates with. But in general, we're seeing it with people who report to have SIBO or report to have IBS.
This is really, really obviously interesting to me and to our audience. So, okay, that's just like my part of my brain is just like now permanently blown. That would be amazing. That would be amazing. Okay, so more on that later. And then, okay, just a few more minutes with you. Are you working? I know you are, I can just tell, but maybe it's not on the top of the list, but is there a probiotic or enzyme coming out to help with weight management?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, we have a whole metabolic health division. And we, you know, I've actually completed recently a study on a prebiotic probiotic mix for weight management. But you know, our focus is, it's not about sensational weight loss. You can do that by going on a cabbage soup diet if you wish, right? Which I did in college and it was absolutely horrific. It's terrible. It's about reprogramming your microbiome so that your microbiome mimics that of a lean person, right? I call it metabolic reprogramming, because it becomes very clear that people who tend to not struggle with weight, who remain lean all their lives, really have a very distinct microbiome. And so that's what we're working on mimicking. And it starts with things like satiety, like the ability to feel full and stop eating, right? That's a very difficult control mechanism that falls apart for a lot of people. And then how your body responds to food, right? So whether or not the food is converted into gases and things that aren't as beneficial, or they're converted to short chain fatty acids, where you get fat burning signals being turned on and so on. So we've got a number of things in the works on metabolic health, because to us, metabolic health is a secondary factor to a dysfunctional microbiome. And so if we can fix the microbiome, we should be able to make significant improvements in metabolic health.
So will it impact blood sugar as well?
Absolutely. In fact, we have a study going on right now with UCLA on pre-diabetes, on blood sugar management. So that's actually initiated and started the study. Hopefully it'll be done by mid-fall. And that's with a probiotic combination.
That's awesome. Okay. The next one's kind of a combo. This is my last question that I have for you. And I know we're running out of time. So thank you so much for spending this time with me. Liver health / psoriasis. Now, mm-hmm. Liver health unto itself needs its own thing, but there's this study that you probably have about a protocol of probiotics to help with psoriasis. Mm-hmm. So what's going on with that?
You know, we actually published a study last year showing that Megaspore provides significant liver protection. even in cases of acute induction of liver toxicity, just taking Megaspore alone protects the liver. So we know that, and we have a lot of docs that use Megaspore for that, for patients that have liver dysfunctions and need that protection for the liver. We also know that liver dysfunction is associated with lots of other health issues, and with SIBO, it's probably right there too. You know, the liver dysfunction is part of that. But we are also working on peptides that have functionality in liver health. So yes, that's one of the key areas that we're looking at as well.
Cool. Well, and also liver and lymph are so related. Liver and lymph are so related, because I know a lot of people listening to us also participated in the Lymphatic Rescue Summit. So I wanted to just pull that in. This is very, 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 very freaking exciting. I'm so
Oh my God. Tell me about it. I'm losing my mind all the time about the opportunities. And, you know, and then the question becomes like, you know, how quickly can we do all this stuff? But we're cranking it out. You know, we're coming out with the Zen Biome in the next month or so. And to me, that's very timely and very needed. Of course, everyone's dealing with exceptional amounts of stress and sleep deprivation and so on. So we need that product that has to be out, and it has to be there to help people. And then we've got the heavy metal binding probiotic, and then the H. pylori binding probiotic. Those are coming out by the end of this year as well. And so will the oral care, the first part, the odor destroying oral care product. And then the pipeline is so full over the next 12 to 18 months.
Fantastic. Thank you so much, Kiran. I'll let you go so you can keep at it. I really appreciate you. Thanks, everybody.
Thank you so much.